Today we're taking a look at Blitzit. It's a Mac application which combines a task and a timer app in one. Today's video is kindly brought to you by SetApp. If you've got a Mac and you want to get access to over 260 different apps available on one subscription, you can check it out in the link in the description below. And just some notes, it's only available for Mac right now. They do plan on introducing an iOS and Android version, both coming soon. But right now, this is the only available version. And I am also testing a beta, just FYI, so that you know. Now, pricing will be on screen. The monthly pricing comes out about between $40 and $50 per year. And also the lifetime plan is, depending on what deal you get, is between 70 and 90. I'll include a link to that below with any deals that we have. But largely, it is varying on price and obviously subject to change. So this right here is Blitzit, and it is a list-based application. So this is basically what you're going to get when you open up. It's sort of like a Kanbanized setup. So you have a backlog over here, which is anything you need to do. And then you have a today area, a done area, so you can see all of the items that you completed. Now, I'll talk about this in a moment, but up here you can see a settings area which you can modify before you get started. Things like the Pomodoro timer, how long you want for your breaks, and things like the alerts for when you've completed. Now, you can also choose what screen you have it on and whether it appears on the right and left. I'll show you what that means in a moment. Now, very simply, this app does connect with other applications like Google Calendar, Notion, and ClickUp. Now, I believe ClickUp's currently in a super beta version at least, but these two are still beta. So be aware of that, with Trello and Asana coming soon. Now, as you can see here, I've added some tasks between this today area, and it's sort of like queuing it up. I can drag tasks to this week, so that's maybe not something I need to do now, but or today, but much and so in the week, and I can move it to the backlog if I wish, drag it back over here. And what I can do here is, before the task actually starts, I can go into here and add some subtasks to break them down. Now, that's something if I wish to do so. I can also add some notes as well, which could be helpful for some of the detailing around it. And I can also go ahead and schedule that for the future, or maybe even change the list it's part of. So as you can see, I can move it outside to another list that it's collectively part of. Now, down here, you'll notice it's Blitzit, and this is where the magic happens. If I press Blitzit, what's going to happen is a full log of what's coming up will appear on the left-hand side. So I can see a timer has started. I can take a break here. I can write some notes as I go, pause it or skip it, or press done. Now, when you press done an item, a nice GIF appears, a animation, and you can also take a break. So if I want to take a break, I can do and go back to this mode. I can also go to the Blitzit and carry on with it. Now, there is something called a focus mode up here, which brings it into a tiny little window, which is movable. The other option is not movable, which is a little bit of a pain, but something that comes as part of this. Now, as you can imagine, you may want to change the settings whilst you're in there. So a little settings panel does appear, which allows you to modify details like the system preferences to the theme. Now, down here, you can also press focus mode. You can't quite see it on this monitor, but you can also see other such completed items like Google Calendar events, which is a little bit sensitive. I'll come to that nearer the end. Now, here is an area that I created earlier, and you can see that I have done a lot of items here, and I can also see all of the items that are coming up. And that's because I've connected up my Google Calendar, which means any calendar event that is uncompleted will appear inside of here. Now, I can modify this slightly so that the sync delete comes in, which means that if anything is deleted here, it'll delete in Google Calendar.
Are you tired of looking for the right app? Well, SetApp gives you instant access to over 260 hand-picked apps for iOS and Mac, all in one place. Whether you need to convert a file, clean your drive, or write that article, just type your task into SetApp and its AI-powered search suggests the perfect app all the time. It's almost as good as having me nearby. Have you got a big goal? And if you have a big goal in mind, you can use SetApp's collections feature. This is a curated bundle of tools for a specific goal in mind. A great way to tackle some complex tasks with a bunch of tools that are available in said app. So each app has user reviews, allowing you to get insight on each of them before you download it, so that you can install each one with confidence. So you can try it today under one subscription, countless possibilities, and that's said app. Link will be below.
So all in all, that's actually all of the package. Now you'll notice over here, you can set something called estimates for each of your tasks, but you can also see what's tracked in each of your tasks as well. And the layer to this is that you get something called reports. Now reports essentially allow you to see what task was completed a certain day. And you can also see other such details like what your most productive hour was, most productive day, or most productive month. And it helps you to break that down with some useful statistics. You can also choose all the different projects that you're working with as well, and go back if you wish. Now, because this is a one-off application, you do get future updates as part of this. So if you do go with the lifetime plan, you will get that saving or baked in as part of that. Now, in terms of Blitzit being an application, who I'd best recommend it for is those on Mac who want a timer and want something simple. Those that aren't looking for something like Todoist or Sensamo or something too, overcomplicated for them, but something that combines with a timer. This application is actually a very good alternative to a popular application in the ADHD space called Llama Life, which again combines that concept of the timer, but doesn't have the routine elements as you can imagine. Now the Notion databases I'll demonstrate on screen, but essentially allows you to bring in a database and connect it with a linked database, which again is helpful for keeping track of what you've got in Notion. So that was hopefully a good overview. Task management and timer all in one, with the ability to do Pomodoro there as well. And again, if you're interested in it, you can find it linked below with any deals that we have. Thank you so much for stopping by, and hopefully it was a good insight into whether Blitzit is right for you.